Young people today are experimenting with a deadly new drug, rabies. Early teens experimented with Seconal, Pantophilinol, or Cocaflexadrine. But today it's rabies. They call it raving out, foaming up, or getting your dog on. In laboratories, rabies is studied scientifically. But often the virus finds its way to youth rallies or after-school get-togethers, such as this one, a concert performance from the group Sum 41. Here we see Busy D transporting the rabies virus through the airwaves. Ground sound bringing rabid riffs to tender ears. Steve-O 32, timid on the outside, but inside one sick puppy. And there's Cone, fully dogged and ready to spread. Does this sound familiar? Does this seem appropriate? Does this look infected? Science is still looking for the answer. A deadly disease is spreading among today's youth. The carrier of this disease is punk rock music. The highly contagious virus is devil worship. So, when observing our young people engaged in musical entertainment, we need to ask, is this the work of Lucifer? Here is the musical quartet known as Sum 41. To the untrained ear, these lyrics seem quite harmless. So am I still waiting for this world to stop hating? Now listen to these same lyrics, played backwards. Why, hello, Satan, my dear friend. Would you like to possess my soul? It really is quite all right by me. Like three sixes tattooed across the buttocks, the mark of the punk rock beast runs deep, starting in childhood. This young Sum 41 fan is building a tiny altar for which to worship the Prince of Darkness, his overlord. Does this look infected? Of course it does. Because Sum 41 and the devil made him do it. A confused or agitated teen is like an open wound. Untreated, it can become problematic. Violent urges are not uncommon, but why would a young person purposefully destroy brand new clothing or an expensive musical instrument? Why, it's almost as ridiculous as propelling your body into a group of strangers or diving onto a crowd of people wearing metal spikes. It's just not good common sense. Much in the same way that frequent masturbation acts as a blinding ice pick, the aggravated rhythm and chaos of punk rock melodies act upon the brain like a deafening hammer, ultimately rendering today's youth into lawless savages capable of knocking over a garbage can or even damaging sheetrock. Social disconnection, moral isolation, ineffective penis enlargement techniques, all factors that contribute to the rise in musical violence among today's youth. Does this look infected? We can only hope we're not too late.